This is a simple example of the geolocation API. You call getCurrentPosition and pass it a callback, and the callback is called when it gets your location and gives you your latitude and longitude. There's also a very similar watchPosition call, which does the same thing except continually calls you every time the position is updated. Let's walk through how we use this API in our conference app. First, we added a button to the map page that triggers the geolocation procedure. When this button is pressed, the trigger geolocation method in our code is called. This code is the heavy lifting of the trigger geolocation method. This uses the HTML5 geolocation API method, getCurrentPosition, and passes it a success callback and an error callback. It also enables high accuracy and sets a timeout. In case of failure, we print a generic, "Sorry, we couldn't find your location." On the other hand, if we succeed, we call a method called elaborateDistance. ElaborateDistance uses the route method from the Google Maps direction service to obtain an object containing information about the route between the user's position and the venue. It then displays some of this information and allows you to open up Google Maps with the route already set. Obviously, this is frequently the way that you'll use geolocation data, that is, passing it off to another control. Most of us don't write code that uses this latitude and longitude directly.